Sources told the Straits Times that Mas Selamat was tracked down based on intelligence provided by Singapore's Internal Security Department, and the capture was a result of a joint operation by security agencies in Malaysia and Singapore. So what is the significance of the capture?
Wanted 13 months ago, now nabbed and behind bars for the past month. Mas Selamat Kastari may have been just one dangerous man, but his capture has crippled terrorist network Jamaah Islamiyah, and authorities, it seems, had foiled another terror plan in the process.
Jamaah Islamiyah has suffered, and this is a major setback for JI. Mas Selamat has been working with JI Malaysia and with Singapore, and his arrest is a clear signal to terrorist groups that they are being fought, and it is also a signal to any terrorist that you can run but you cannot hide. Eventually you will be caught and you will be punished.
But there is still more work for the security agencies, as terrorism activity has not totally been snuffed out in the Southeast Asian region.
Terrorist groups are moving away from operational terrorism, meaning conducting attacks, towards radicalizing and politicizing a larger group of people, larger population, particularly the youth. So the next wave of threat will come more from extremism and from radicalism rather than operational terrorism. So there's more intellectual and ideological investment on the part of terrorist groups by printing books, propaganda, radicalizing people. That is why governments need to work together with the education ministries, with the schools, with the religious ministries, working with the Muslim schools, with the mosques and with Muslim associations to educate the people that Al-Qaeda and Jamaah Islamiyah are not Quranic groups, that they are deviant and heretical groups.
And so it looks like the battle to win minds away from terror will have to continue. And it is a campaign that extends beyond security agencies.